Hi, y'all. It's me again. And we, as I've told you before, we're celebrating our 65th year of being in ministry. Amazing, amazing what God has done for his little ones here at Faith City Mission. It's just been wonderful. And of course, we appreciate so much what our donors do for us, in that without them, you donors, we couldn't do any of this. We don't take federal funding. We don't take United Way funding. We don't take anything but private donations. And with that money, we're faithful to be really faithful to the money that's given to us, knowing that it's from God, and how we handle that is imperative, that we do that with the utmost integrity. And so 65 years of great donors that help us help the poor and help the addicted. So a big thank you for all of you that donate. But I want to tell you another story. It's a great one. It was a while back. There was a gentleman that came to our program. He was probably in his 40s. He looked like he had the complexion of concrete. It was gray and pasty, and he was actually had been diagnosed HIV positive for 15 years, forever. And of course, drug use and so forth had decimated his body. At any rate, he did a great job in the program. He worked his program. He worked hard to get clean and sober. And so he graduated, and he was such a hard worker that I put him on staff in the kitchen in order to help out with all the food that we prepared. Again, we prepare about 84,000 meals a year, so it takes an army to get that to happen. And at any rate, he was doing super. And one day he came to me and he said, "Mrs. Taylor, there's a melanoma on my back, and it's going to be biopsied this week. Would you and your staff, would you pray for me?" And I said, "Absolutely, we'd love to pray for you." So after staff meeting, we actually did gather around and lay our hands on him, and everyone just prayed the sweetest prayer, you know, to be healed from the top of his head to the bottom of his feet. And that was that. You know, I wouldn't say we heard bells and whistles or exciting things, you know, go off at the moment. But at any rate, that was on a Wednesday in staff meeting. The following Monday, I came to work, and I walked in the lobby. It was full of people, and they're all crying, and that's never good. So I said, "What happened?" And no one's paying any attention to me. I said, "No, what's happened here?" And suddenly there was a parting of all these bodies, and there was this gentleman, and he was sobbing. I said, "Oh, hon, what did you find out? What happened?" And he said, "I need you to listen to this." And he had his cell phone, and he pushed his messages and put it on speaker. And I heard this doctor's voice with my own ears, and he said, "This is Dr. Patapathy, and I have the results of your biopsy. And so to tell you this, it is not cancerous. You're fine. We'll just freeze it off. But in addition to that, I need to tell you that you're not testing positive for HIV, the virus, any longer." He said, "I don't know what you're doing, but keep doing it." And that was that. And so then I'm sobbing. I'm crying. "I can't believe this. You no longer have HIV. Oh my gosh, you're not HIV positive. Oh my gosh, after 15 years, and the Lord just heals you instantly, and you have your life back." This young man got his life back. Amazing story, amazing story. And he rejoiced, we rejoiced. I was 30 minutes sobbing, crying, jag in the lobby. No makeup the rest of the day, but oh, what a great story. God knew this young man, knew the sin he'd walked in, knew the drugs he'd walked in, and the things he'd done. And you know what? He is so kind, because that young man came to know him. That young man came to serve him. And God, in his goodness and his kindness, Oh, his grace and his mercy, really mercy. You know, mercy is when you deserve a spanking and you don't get it, because that's his mercy. And so I had to tell you that story. He's doing great, still is doing great. He's moved on now from working with us, but just an amazing young man. And I'm so glad to see if God can do that, if he can reverse HIV positive, he can do anything. So whatever it is that you might be facing today, physical or otherwise, remember this story. Remember the story of the young man contracting HIV and God healing him just because he can. Just because he's that kind and tender and sweet to his people. So I had to share that with you today. I hope you have a great day. It's going to be a good day. Great things are going to happen. Miracles are going to happen today. And I'm excited to see how I get to be a part. So God bless.